Park mobile game, yuck. I truly believe this game is something very special. And before I explain why, let me just explain what the game is. Soaring is an open-world action survival game, where the player will be able to step into the shoes of four playable dinosaurs, living out their natural lives in the real-life Hell Creek Formation, one of, if not the best-preserved Cretaceous fossil beds in the world. You will start the game as a defenseless hatchling and must survive to adulthood by avoiding many of the countless perils that await you in Hell Creek. From not only crocodilians, giant lizards, basically flying giraffes, and, yes, even T-Rex, but also the environment itself. You will get to step into the shoes of both the predators and the prey, as the game will let you choose between playing as a Pachycephalosaurus, Triceratops, Dakota Raptor, and yes, the famous T-Rex. Each dinosaur carrying their own unique attributes and traits. Some dinosaurs are faster, some dinosaurs are slower, some are stronger, and some are just downright terrifying. As an animal, you must hunt, eat, sleep, drink, mate, and do whatever the heck this is in order to survive in your environment that is almost entirely unpredictable. I conducted an interview with the project's leader, Nick Terranen, and I'll just let him take it from here.
So, essentially, gameplay is never stagnant. You're always getting a new experience as you live longer and survive longer. And I think the other big thing to take away is that eventually the goal is that the environment should be as big a challenge to survive as the other animals living in it. You know, that this isn't just a static world that you exist in. This world is dynamic. This world has, you know, threats and opportunities in it that you can exploit or avoid just as easily as you have to avoid a predator or a rival.
Even by just growing up, the player must adapt his or her playing style to differences in growth stages. The game is almost entirely unpredictable and allow the players to have a unique experience almost every single time. The game will be filled with literally dozens of species of NPCs, all of which were real and would have been encountered in the real Hell Creek. It will have everything from the smallest lizards of Hell Creek to the largest sauropods, from Mosasaurus to the beautiful Anatosaurus to the extremely threatening T-Rexes. And let me just be the first to say that these are the best dinosaur models, designs, graphics, and just all-around depictions I've ever seen in a video game, and probably in pop culture in general. And it's not like these are fantasy designs. Nick explains everything that is in the game has a scientific basis, from the bizarre nasal pouch of the sauropod, to the spiny tail of a Pachycephalosaurus, to the coloration of all the animals of Hell Creek. All of them have some scientific basis and are the most accurate depictions of prehistoric animals in alignment to what we currently know about the period. They're absolutely beautifully modeled and designed, but they're also equally beautiful and organically animated. Just look at that animation. Look at it. And guess what?
And then that's really, he's really an awesome person from the sense that, like, he's a self-taught animator. He didn't go to school to learn any of these. He didn't,